It was 2006 when Honda launched the original Civic in India. And that car became a smash hit primarily because of two reasons. One, it looked super futuristic. And two, it drove really well. But we all know how that went. That car was eventually phased out in 2012 because of the lack of a diesel option. Fast forward to 2019, the Honda Civic is back in a brand new avatar. And now it looks like this. But it's worth noting that things are pretty awkward for this all-new Civic. Reasons? Number one, the executive sedan segment is shrinking as a whole because of people's newfound love for SUVs. And number two, even though the Civic is now available with a diesel engine, the demand for diesel engine cars is shrinking as a whole. So, with everything going against it, how does the new Civic fare? While it may not be as futuristic as its predecessor, the new Civic is a very cool-looking car nonetheless. Its long and wide stance ensures that it grabs many eyeballs wherever it goes. Alright, so the cabin of the new Civic is quite a sporty place to be in, as you can see. Everything is quite driver-centric, which is pretty essential for a sporty sedan. In terms of quality, the materials up here are soft touch, but everything below that is hard and shiny plastic. Overall, it's pretty average for a car that costs around Rs. 25 lakh. Obviously, something like a Skoda Octavia would offer you much better build quality than this one. But what you must keep in mind is that Civics are renowned for their reliability. So everything right here is not gonna fall apart for years to come. You see this sweeping coupe-like roofline? It gives the car a very slick look. But as you'd expect, there's a trade-off. Let me show you what. And this is what I was talking about. You see, I'm 5 feet 10 inches tall and I barely have any headroom here. So if you're taller than me and you prefer to be driven around in your Civic, then I've got some bad news for you. On the other hand, the legroom is plenty. Just look at the amount of space I've got here. Now many of you would be surprised to learn that the 1.8-litre iVTEC petrol engine powering this car is a modified version of the very same engine which was seen on the previous Civic. Obviously, the diesel-engined Civic generated much more hype earlier this year when this car was launched. But the sales figures say otherwise. Around 80% of the people are buying this very variant of the Civic. So as you'd expect from a Honda iVTEC, the engine is brilliantly refined. It gets full marks on refinement levels. But where this engine severely lacks is performance. You see, 140 horsepower isn't enough in this segment by today's standards. And this becomes even more evident when you consider that the Skoda Octavia makes 40 more horsepower than this car. On top of that, this engine is only available with a 7-step CVT gearbox, so there's no manual option here. This engine in itself is a bit underpowered, and when you combine it with CVT, you end up with a car that's a bit underwhelming in terms of straight line acceleration. So when I say underwhelming, I mean underwhelming by sedan standards. You see, sedans are lighter and more aerodynamic, so we expect them to be faster than equally priced SUVs. But in the case of this Civic, while it's gonna keep up with most similarly priced SUVs, it's the slowest sedan in its class. The 0 to 100 sprint takes more than 11 seconds on both petrol and diesel engine models. So this CVT gearbox also has 7-step paddle shifts, which helps you play around with the CVT ratios. There's also a sports mode, which is actually optimized for paddle shift usage. But at the end of the day, it's still a CVT. So when you floor the gas pedal, you can hear that the engine goes pretty gruff, but you're not going at the kind of pace that the engine note might suggest. That's typical of that CVT rubber band effect. But it must be noted that this CVT, with its quick response and extremely linear power delivery, makes for a perfect city gearbox. So if your daily commute includes bumper-to-bumper traffic every day, then you're gonna be quite pleased with this gearbox. An area where the Civic absolutely shines is in terms of handling. In fact, it won't be an exaggeration to say that the Civic is the best handling mainstream car for under Rs. 30 lakh. The steering balance here is spot on, and the car takes on corners like a pro thanks to its low stance. So, if you take driving seriously, then you just can't afford to overlook this car. So when I say that a car handles really well, the first thing that comes in your mind is that the ride quality is gonna be quite stiff. However, I'm happy to inform that Honda has nailed the ride and handling balance here. As you can see, the road I'm driving on is pretty terrible. And the imperfections of the road are pretty well filtered. So in terms of ride and handling balance, it's a very accomplished car. But just because you're getting awesome handling doesn't mean that you have to compromise on ride quality. So despite its lack of power, which is its major flaw, the Honda Civic is a very accomplished car. So in what scenario should you consider buying one? Well, if you've not been bitten by the SUV bug, congrats for that first. And you're looking for a self-driven premium sedan that looks great, handles like a champ, and would be easy to maintain in the long run, then the Honda Civic is seriously worth a consideration.